गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास दैट इज क्लास टू फॉर द चैप्टर बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट इन केमिस्ट्री आई ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल्स फॉर गिविंग द नेम ऑफ ए ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड अकॉर्डिंग टू आईपीएससी सिस्टम. टुडे दैट इज क्लास थ्री. I will try to focus giving the IPSC name of some individual functional groups. Next, IPSC naming for aromatic compound. Next, how to write the name of an organic compound if formula is there. We have to draw the structure and finally the bond line notation, how to represent the formula of a compound in bond line form. So let us, before starting the today class, it is necessary to recap a little bit about the fundamental principles for naming according to IPCC system. First thing, select the longest continuous carbon chain which is treated as the main chain or parent chain, which may or may not be one straight chain, and some groups which are not included in the main chain then treated as the substituent or branching. One important thing you have to remember that if the organic compound containing functional group, then we have to select the longest chain or the main chain in such a way that it must contain that functional group containing carbon atom, which may or may not be a longest one. Next, after selecting the main chain and the substituent, it is necessary for numbering, giving the locant number, identifying the position of the substituent, and it is carried out either from left to right or from right to left in such a way that which gives lowest locant number. That means the substituent or branching possess lowest number as far as possible. Next, if it has been observed that branching is there, more than one branching is there, then we have to select the longest chain or the main chain in such a way that it possesses maximum branching. Next, if functional group is there but not contain carbon, then we have to select the main chain in such a way that the functional group not included in the main chain but the functional group attached to the carbon atom must possess lowest locant number. Next, if main chain contain both multiple bond, means double bond or triple bond, then numbering should be in such a way that either double bond or triple bond must possess least number. For example, mark that while writing a formula, it is important to note that each carbon must possess its tetracovalency. So here double bond is there, triple bond is there. If we numbering from left to right, mark that multiple bond that is attached to first carbon atom, double bond, and triple bond attached to third carbon atom. While if we move from right to left, then triple bond attached to second carbon atom and double bond attached to fourth carbon atom. So in which side we observe that the multiple bond possess least lowest Locard number, that is from left to right, that is 1. So numbering from left to right. Okay, so in this case two important point you have to remember. One is priority given for numbering, and point two, priority given for giving suffix, as both are functional group ENE and YNE. Remember that always a priority for numbering given which one possesses lowest Locard number. If from both sides double bond and triple bond possess lowest Locard number, then a priority given from the double bond side. But in every cases, while giving the principal functional group behave as suffix, always a priority given for triple bond. Mark that. So its name is, as no substituent is there, pent 1 EN and 3 YNE. Another one important thing you have to remember, that means if secondary suffix begins with A, E, I, O, U and Y, then the principal suffix, that is primary suffix ANE or ENE, that is drop. Okay, but if two triple bond is there or two double bond is there, then we say it is di YNE, di ENE. Then in that case, as starts with D, so in that E is not removed. Okay, for example, mark that. In this case, if you move from left to right, then it is 1. If you move right to left, also multiple bond possess 1 number. Same thing there. Then priority for numbering, that is from double bond side. But while giving the suffix, the principal functional group, that is always YNE. So numbering from left to right, it is pent 1 EN, 4 YNE. Okay. Then next, if more than one functional group, that is known as a polyfunctional group, is there, then a priority table is there. On the basis of a priority table, we have to remember by that priority table, on that basis, that functional group present at the top of the priority table behave as principal functional group and used as a suffix, while that functional group present at the bottom of the priority table taken as secondary functional group, which is behave as prefix. For example, mark that. It is one formula is there, where CHO is a functional group, COOH also a functional group. Then if a single functional group COOH, then it is suffix is oic acid. And if single functional group is there, then it is known as AL. But as both functional group present in one compound, then on the basis of priority, COOH behave as principal functional group, while CHO behave as secondary functional group, which is used as a prefix. And here, two different type of naming is there. One, mark that. So numbering from right to left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If CHO is included in the mention, then I rewrite this one. It is used as a ketone group. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one, no doubt it is aldehyde, but here used as a keto group. So its name is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As 5 carbon atom is there, so the root word is pent, and it is used as a prefix or used as a secondary functional group, used as a prefix. So it is used as aldo, or also it is used as a keto. In this case, its name is, that is 5-oxo-pentanoic acid. On the other hand, if it is behave as a branching, then numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4. This CHO attached to 4 point, so it is known as 4-formyl butanoic acid. Okay, similarly, mark that another one is there. Here two functional group is there, one is alcohol, one is aldehyde. If we mark on the basis of priority table, then aldehyde is more powerful than alcohol. So it is used as a suffix al, while it is used as a prefix hydroxy. So numbering from left to right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is at 4 position, so 4-hydroxy-pentanal. Okay, it is a little bit idea about the previous class. Then switch over to giving the IPAC name of individual functional group. Mark that. One is ether. Representation is ROR-. Here functional group is O. General representation ROR-. Its IPAC name is alkoxy. It is IUPAC name alkoxy alkane. Generally, two type of alkyl group is there, which may or may not be equal. That one alkyl group contain lower number of carbon atom, taken as alkoxy, and that alkyl group contain higher number of carbon atom, taken as alkane. Mark that. CH3 CH2 OCH3 B2 1. So it is one formula. It is one group, alkyl group. It is one alkyl group. Two carbon atom, it is known as ethyl. One carbon atom, known as methyl. So first thing, we have to select the longest chain. This one is the main chain, parent chain. It is known as a substituent. So substituent taken as the alkoxy, main chain taken as the alkane. So its name is methoxy ethane. Alkoxy, as one carbon is there, so methoxy. Main chain is alkane. As two carbon atom is there, ethane. Okay, mark that another example. CH3 CH2 O CH2 CH3. In this case, both the side possess same number of carbon atom. You may select anyone as the main chain. Suppose this one is the main chain, then it is known as a substituent. So its name is, two group is, two carbon is there, so ethoxy ethane. If the two substituent possess same carbon atom, one can select anyone as the main chain. Okay, another example, that is CH3 O CH CH3 CH3. Mark that. If this is the case, then we have to select the longest chain. So now this one is the longest chain. Then numbering, either you select 1, 2, 3 or you select 1, 2, 3. At 2 position, it is the substituent as branching. So its name as 1 carbon, it is known as 2-methoxy. Because this alkoxy, the substituent attached to 2 position, so it is known as 2-methoxy. And main chain, 3 carbon, propane. Okay, mark that. Another one example also. Whatever may be the formula, first thing you have to select the longest chain, then give the name, then after give the formula, that is alkoxy alkane. Mark that. Another also, CH2 double bond CH, CH2O, CH3, CH3. Mark that. Another one formula is there. That is CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2, single bond O, then CH3. If this is the case, then first thing we have to select the main chain. This one is the main chain, mark that. This one is the main chain. Then numbering, as the functional group is there, numbering 1, 2, 3. 3 position, it is the substituent. So 3 methoxy propene, either one can write a prop ene or a propene. Okay, good. It is a little bit idea about the functional group ether. Next, switch over to another one functional group, that is ester. Ester is nothing but the derivative of carboxylic acid. We know that the carboxylic acid represent, that is RCOOH, mark that. It is known as acid, carboxylic acid. So from this we have to derive another group, functional group. That's why these are known as derivative of carboxylic acid. Mark that. RCOCl minus OH plus Cl, then RCONH2. Here minus OH plus NH2, then RCOOR dash minus OH, add OR dash. Another one is that RCOOCOR, here minus OH plus add C double bond OR. These are the compound, organic compound, derived from the carboxylic acid. That's why these are known as acid derivative. Its name is, common name, acid chloride. IUPAC name is alkanoyl chloride. If one carbon atom, then methanoyl chloride. Two carbon atom, ethanoyl chloride. Three carbon atom, propanoyl chloride. Similarly, its name is, common name, acid amide. IUPAC name is alkanamide. If organic compound contain one carbon atom, that is HCONH2, formamide, methanamide, common name is formamide, IUPAC name is methanamide. If two carbon atom, ethanamide. Three carbon atom, propanamide, like this one. Okay, next one is ester. It is RCOOR dash. This R and R dash may be same or not in the formula. There is no hard and fast that both are same or differ. Its name is alkyl alkanoate. It is the prefix alkyl and it is mentioned, that is suffix alkanoate. How it is, you discuss later. Next, it is known as acid anhydride. So this, how these two nomenclature going on, we discuss later one by one. So these are known as acid derivative because these are derived from the acid. Now we discuss first the IBSC nomenclature of Easter. Mark that, how it is carried out. Easter representation R C O O R dash. IPS name is alkyl alkanoate. Some examples, mark that. CH3 C O O CH3. H C O O CH3. CH3 COO C2H5 CH3 CH2 COO CH3. Mark that, some esters are there. How IPSC name given? So whatever may be the size of the alkyl group, always this side, this alkyl group is taken as always prefix, that is alkyl. And the rest one is alkanoate. I repeat again. Whether how many number of carbon, irrespective of the number of carbon atom present in the right side, after oxygen taken as alkyl, while the rest are known as alkanoate. So mark that, its name is one carbon atom, methyl. Then total how many carbon atom? Two carbon atom. So ethanoate. Okay, mark that similarly, it is one carbon atom, methyl. In total, how many carbon atom? One carbon atom, methanoate. Next, here two carbon atom, ethyl. Next, how many carbon atom? Two carbon atom, ethanoate. Similarly, here one carbon atom, methyl. Next, rest 1, 2, 3, 3 carbon atom, propanoate. Okay, so it is little idea about giving the name of ester. Next, switch over to another one functional group, that is acid anhydride. Next functional group is acid anhydride. These are known as a derivative of function monocarboxylic acid, that is known as acid anhydride, represented by R C O O C O R. We may write here R or we may write R dash. Its IPSC name is alkanoic anhydride. IPSC name is alkanoic anhydride. Mark that, how it is possible. Some examples, CH3 CO O CO CH3 CH3 CO O CO CH3 CH2. Mark that, two examples are given. So you divide here making an imaginary line. And mark that if both the component remain same, then it is known as alkanoic anhydride. How many carbon atom in one component? Two carbon atom. So its name is ethanoic anhydride. Okay, similarly draw one imaginary line. Mark that two component same or not. Here two component are differ. Here two carbon atom, here three carbon atom. If it two carbon atom, its name is ethanoic. If its name is ethanoic. If three carbon atom, its name is propanoic. So if two fragment differ one, then we follow alphabetical order. Which one first? This one first. So its name is ethanoic, next propanoic anhydride. Okay, I remind again, mark that after giving the imaginary line, if you observe two fragment remain same, two group contain same carbon atom, then select in one component how many carbon atom? Two. So it is ethanoic. If one, methanoic. If three, propanoic. Okay. On the other hand, if two component differ in number of carbon atom, then follow alphabetical order. It is about the acid anhydride. Next, switch to another one is, that is amine. It is important one. That is, next we switch over to the nomenclature of amine. Amines. That is mark that three types of amines are there. That is known as primary amine, secondary amine, and tertiary amine. That is 1 degree amine, 2 degree amine, and 3 degree amine. Each are derived from ammonia. Mark that. That is NH3. We have to derive how? Minus, replace one H, add one alkyl group, then it is known as RNH2. Okay? Replace 2H, add two alkyl group, then it is known as RRNH, or one can write RNHR. Here, it is to be remembered that both the alkyl group may be same or differ. Similarly, here, replace 3 hydrogen atom, add 3 alkyl group. It is known as RRRN, or one can write RNR, or one can write R dash R double dash. So, it is known as 1 degree amine. Or a primary amine, it is known as 2 degree amine, or secondary amine, it is known as 3 degree amine, or tertiary amine. Okay. In a primary amine, the functional group is NH2, that is amino. In secondary amine, functional group is NH, that is imino. And tertiary amine, functional group is N, that is a tertiary nitrogen. Okay, so let us ready giving the IPSC nomenclature for 1 degree amine, 2 degree amine, and 3 degree amine one by one. First, we select the primary amine. Mark that. First is primary amine, that is RNH2. Here functional group NH2, suffix amine, prefix amino. So IPSC name, its IPSC name is alkana amine means alkane minus E plus amine. It is known as a primary amine or 1 degree amine. Mark that some examples. CH3, CH2, CH2, NH2. Next, CH3, CH2, CH, NH2, CH3. Next, CH3, 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 NH2. So question arises, how one is able to know whether it is a primary amine or secondary amine or tertiary amine? That means whether it is 1 degree or 2 degree or 3 degree. Focus to the functional group. Whatever may be the nature of the carbon atom, whatever may be the nature of the chain, whatever may be the number of carbon atom, not necessary, focus to the functional group. If it is NH2, then it is 1 degree. If it is NH, then 2 degree. Or if it is N, then it is 3 degree. So, in this case, we observe that it is NH2, it is NH2, it is NH2. So, irrespective of the nature of the chain, carbon chain, The three are comes under primary. Next, giving the name. So first thing, we have to select the mention. We have to select the mention. And three carbon atom is there. So its name is alkene plus amine. That means propanamine. Okay. Similarly, select the mention. Then numbering, because this one group, functional group, must be possess lowest number, its locand number. So numbering from right to left, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is known as butan 2-amine. Because its name, IPS name is alkene amine. Alkene, 4 carbon atom, butane, remove E, and this amine attached to 2 position. So butan 2-amine. Okay. Similarly here, select the mention. One can select 1, 2, 3. One can select 1, 2, 3, or one can select 1, 2, 3. No problem is there. It is known as substituent. So numbering 1, 2, 3. So it is a substituent 2 position. So its name is 2-methyl propan 2-amine. Mark that. Mention. 3 carbon atom, substituent, present at 2 position, so 2-methyl, next rootward, propane, and this functional group attached to 2 carbon, so its name is 2-methyl propane 2-amine. Okay, so it is little idea about the IPSC nomenclature for 1 degree amine. Next, switch over to 2 degree amine. 2 degree amine, or it is known as secondary amine. Like primary amine, how you know whether it is secondary amine or not? Answer very simple. Irrespective of the nature of the carbon chain, mark that. What is the functional group is there? If it is NH, then it is sure it belongs to secondary amine. Mark that. Next is secondary amines, or known as a 2 degree amine. It is RNHR, or one can write RNHR dash. So here IPSC name is N alkyl alkanamine. N alkyl alkanamine, this one is the known as substituent. It is the main chain. This substituent attached to nitrogen, so its name is N-alkyl alkanamine. Let us verify, giving some examples. CH3, NH, CH3, CH3, NH, CH2, CH3, CH3, CH2, NH, CH2, CH3. CH3, CH2, CH2, NH, CH3. Mark that. In each case, we have to select the longest chain known as a parent chain. Then after selecting, its name is, the substituent name is N-alkyl alkanamine. So here, after the functional group, both sides same number of carbon atom. So one can select anyone as the main chain. It is known as the main chain, and it is known as the branching or substituent. After selecting the main chain and branching behave as alkyl, and this is attached to nitrogen, so N-alkyl. In this case, how many carbon atom? One carbon atom, so its name is N-methyl, then alkanamine. It is the main chain. How many carbon atom? One carbon atom, so its name is N-methyl-methanamine. Okay, move to the second one. Mark that. It is the main chain. It is known as main chain or parent chain because contain maximum number of carbon atoms. So now it is known as a substituent. So its name is, it is attached to N. So N-methyl, N-alkyl, N-methyl, alkanamin, 2 carbon, ethanamin. So its name is, what is its name? N-methyl ethanamin. Okay, move to the next one. Mark that here 2 carbon atom, here 2 carbon atom. Anyone select as the mentioned. So I select it is the mention, it is a substituent. So it is alkyl attached to an N alkyl. How many carbon atom? 2 carbon atom. So its name is N ethyl ethanamine. Similarly, now it is a mention, it is a substituent. Its name is N methyl propanamine. Okay, any doubt? No doubt. Good. It is all about the secondary amine. Next, switch over to tertiary amine. Tertiary amine, or it is known as 3-degree amine. Like in primary and secondary amine, a doubt is there whether how we know the amine given in the formula belongs to primary or secondary or tertiary. Simple idea, that means simple answer, focus to the functional group. Irrespective of the nature of the carbon chain, we have to focus the functional group. If it is N, then it is known as tertiary amine. Mark that, then we select to tertiary amine or 3-degree amines, represented as RRRN. And IPSC name here, IPSC name is 2.2 different types is there. Depending upon the condition, 2 different IPSC name is there. One is NN dialkyl alkanamine, and another is N alkyl alkanamine. 2 condition, I repeat again here. If R is equal to R dash, here if R is not equal to R dash, 2 condition is there. Let us discuss one by one. Mark that. I rewrite this one again. R, N, R dash, R double dash. The 3 alkyl group may be same or not. So in order to identify the different alkyl group, I represent it is R, R dash, R double dash. Each one treated as the alkyl group having same formula CnH2n+1. Okay. So first thing is that identify that N is there, so it is known as a tertiary amine. After identifying the tertiary amine, it is necessary to select the main chain, longest continuous carbon chain. Suppose I selected the longest chain known as main chain or parent chain. You may select this one or you may select this one. Suppose I select it is the main chain. Then these two is known as the substituent. Okay. Then 2 cases arises. Case 1, these 2 substituent becomes equal. Or case 2, the 2 substituent, 2 alkyl group becomes different. Yes or no? Any other condition arises? No. Only 2 condition. These 2 substituent or branching may be equal or not equal. So depending upon the condition, if 2 substituent are equal, then its name is NN dialkyl alkanamine. On the other hand, if 2 substituent are different, then on the basis of alphabetical order, its name is N. N stands for nitrogen. N alkyl alkanamine. Okay, any doubt? Let us select some examples to identify this one. I select some formula is there to identify how the IPSC name is going on in case of 3-degree amine. Mark that. CH3, N, CH3, CH2, CH3. Second, CH3, CH2, NCH2, CH3, CH3, third, CH3, CH2, CH2, NCH2, CH3, CH3. Mark that. Some formula is there. I discuss one by one. So one thing is that as the functional group N is there, we identify that it is a tertiary amine. Next, select the main chain. Mark that here. This one is the known as a main chain because of maximum number of carbon atom. So after selecting main chain, we observe that the two substituents remain same. So its name is N-N-dialkyl. Its name is methyl attached to N. Its name is methyl attached to N. So its name is N-N-dimethyl. Then alkanamine, main chain contain two. So its name is ethanamine. Okay, good. Move to here. Mark that it is the two carbon atom. Anyone can select anyone as the main chain. Suppose it is then I select it the parent chain or main chain. Then these two are the substituent. And these two alkyl group are different because it is methyl, it is ethyl. So if two substituents are differ, then follow alphabetical order. Its name is methyl, its name is ethyl. So its name is N-ethyl, N-methyl, then mention two carbon atom, ethanamine. Okay, move to the second one. Mark that it is known as a main chain because of contain maximum number of carbon atom. Then this one is known as the substituent, and both the substituent are differ one. So we follow alphabetical order. It is ethyl attached to N, it is methyl attached to N. So what is its name? Its name is N-ethyl, N-methyl, propanamine. Okay, good. It is a little idea about giving the IPSC name for individual functional group.